Hi, in this video, we're excited to introduce to you the latest update to Dubbler 2, the MIDI Capture plugin. So MIDI Capture is a free update that helps you record cleaner pitch MIDI with Dubbler and allows you to drag and drop recordings directly in your DAW. So let's take a look at a quick example of how you can use MIDI Capture. So here in my DAW, I have a loop that I want to record over. And I also have a synth here that I'm controlling live with Dubbler 2. What I also have in this project is a track here with the Dubbler MIDI Capture plugin on. So with MIDI Capture, I can press the space bar, sing my melody in, and the idea will be recorded directly as a clip in this plugin. So when I stop playing, we now have a MIDI clip at the top of the plugin here, and a cleaning algorithm is also applied. So the clip is automatically cleaned, adjusting for latency and removing any unwanted notes or mistakes that I might have made while singing. I can now click and drag this clip over to our track, and we can see the MIDI clip here and listen to that back. So let's take a bit of a deeper look into how this works. The MIDI Capture plugin works with any DAW that supports VST3 or audio units, and you can find it as an instrument in your DAW's usual plugin list, and we can then add it to an empty MIDI track. Once the plugin's added, it needs to connect to the Dubbler 2 software, which you can open directly from the plugin. The MIDI Capture plugin works as a companion to the Dubbler app and reflects changes and settings that we have in our profile, such as keylock, for example. MIDI Capture is simply recording and cleaning what you sing in the Dubbler 2 app. Dubbler is still what's translating your voice into MIDI information, so it's important to remember you have your mic properly calibrated with Dubbler. Once the Dubbler app's configured correctly, you can see in the bottom left that it's connected to the Dubbler VST, and we're now ready to record. So just like we had in our example, we can set up a separate track with a sound that we want to control and arm it to receive MIDI information in real time from Dubbler 2. The track that's containing MIDI Capture does not need to be armed, and all we need to do is press spacebar to start recording with it. We do not need to press record in our DAW unless you also want to record the idea you're singing in real time as well. So let's record another quick example, and whilst I'm doing that, you'll also see the pitch that's being recorded live. Once you press spacebar again, recording will be disabled and you'll see your MIDI clip available at the top. MIDI Capture will offer both a raw and a clean version of the clip, meaning we can decide whether we want the cleaning algorithm applied or not. The cleaning algorithm removes unwanted ghost notes and any leftover latency. So you can see in the raw version, there's a few extra notes here than the four that I was just intending to sing. But once you're happy with the clip, you can click and drag it anywhere you like in your project. You may get a prompt asking if you want to import the tempo or BPM or time signature of the clip, but we can just press no if we want. MIDI Capture will use the BPM set in your DAW when you start recording, meaning the clip will always fit in your project. If we want to record again, we always need to go back to the plugin and make sure we click Enable Recording. And once that's done, we can then hit spacebar to overwrite our previous clip. Currently, MIDI Capture only works with pitch, but support for triggers and chords will be coming in future updates. So that's an overview of the MIDI Capture plugin. If you need, there's some more detailed setup instructions depending on the DAW you're using over on the Learn page on our website.